Hi, I'm Alex, and this is Jasmine. We're going to tell you about the loading station, which is where human players deliver hatch panels and cargo to robots on the field. There's a loading station at each end of each Alliance wall.
Each loading station has three vertical openings on the field side of the station. The top one is square and is where cargo enters the field. A drive team member feeds the cargo from the Alliance side through a chute. There is no door on the chute, so cargo put in the chute heads right through to the field. Humans, check the manual for rules about keeping body parts out of the chute.
The middle opening is where hatch panels enter the field. Human players place the panels into the circular slot, and the panel falls down through the station and is caught by pins and held in place by brushes. Once settled, the hatch panel is at the same level as the hatches on the cargo ship and the lower hatches on the rockets. When placing panels in the loading station, be careful to ensure there isn't already a panel in the station, as two panels in the station may cause it to jam. Also be aware that cargo that ends up in front of the loading station may make it difficult to remove the panels.
Speaking of retrieving hatch panels, check out the backstops on the top and bottom of the hatches. These backstops mirror what's on the cargo ship and will limit the reachable depth of the hatch in these areas to about 3 inches. The bottom opening in the loading station makes room for robot bumpers, just like on the cargo ship. These openings are positioned so there's space, get it? Like the theme? For robot bumpers in the Alliance station.
Did you just come up with that, or did you plan it?
I apologize. Anyway, back to the bumpers. Don't worry, there's a metal guard behind each opening to keep humans from contact by the robots. Good luck, everyone. Hope your season is out of this world.